Sometimes it just takes two to tango. SN2 refers to both a reaction which replaces a leaving group with a nucleophile, as well as the specific mechanism by which it happens. The key players are the substrate, an alkyl molecule with a leaving group on a saturated carbon, the leaving group, a substituent that can be easily removed and is stable in solution, and the nucleophile, an electron donor which can displace a leaving group. SN2 stands for substitution, nucleophilic, bimolecular, which means both reagents play an active role throughout the reaction. This is reflected in the rate equation, which takes into account the concentration of both the nucleophile and the substrate. The reaction in question is comically named the backside attack, which refers to the nucleophilic addition on the side opposite of a leaving group. There is a short-lived transition state, which includes both the nucleophile and the leaving group. During this transition state, one of the five groups stemming from the carbon must be ejected to maintain an octet. Though it is theoretically possible for any of the five groups to be ejected, chances are higher for groups that are more stable when ejected. Due to the direction the nucleophile must attack from, there is a 100% inversion rate of stereochemistry. Leaving groups are specifically chosen to have a favorable chance of elimination. Traits like stability in solution and low nucleophilic activity are primary considerations so as to not compete with a nucleophile's addition. Groups like halides, tosylates, triflates, and water are all good leaving groups. Other factors such as the substrate also play a role in the viability and rate of an SN2 reaction. The principal factor is steric hindrance. If the carbon with the leaving group has multiple large substituents, the reaction may be slow or altogether unviable. The more open the carbon is, the faster the reaction. Solvent also has a large effect on the feasibility of an SN2 reaction. A polar, aprotic solvent is ideal, able to stabilize a leaving group, but does not offer hydrogen bonding to available nucleophiles. Protic solvents will often trap nucleophiles in a network of hydrogen bonds, sometimes referred to as a solvent cage. Solvents like tetrahydrofuran, acetone, and DMSO are all good candidates. These properties make the SN2 mechanism distinct from SN1. It is possible to have the two mechanisms compete, but reaction conditions will generally ensure that one is dominant over the other. Reaction conditions, products, and even reagents themselves can lend clues to the type of mechanism that will dominate. Conditions do limit when SN2 can be used, however. The available substituents and geometry of the substrate will determine the feasibility of an SN2 substitution. If the reagent is not soluble in any polar aprotic solvents, SN2 might also be ruled out, but solubility is mostly a laboratory concern and not generally considered in a classroom setting. The SN2 reaction is an easy way to install specific substituents. Where other methods may need multiple steps to get to the desired product, SN2 can finish the job in just one. Thank you for watching, and join us next time when we'll look at an ironic pair of lone wolf reactions.